Gananatha, Gananatha,
Gananatha, Gananatha,
Gananatha, Gananatha,
Gananatha, Gananatha,
Vighna Vinashaka Gananatha,
Vighna Vinashaka
Gananatha,
Namaskar everyone and welcome to the Hindu Prachar Kendra's Sunday morning Satsang. It's always a pleasure to have you join us. This morning we are here again in the home of one of our Kendra families for a second week. Of course we have to make this adjustment for a while because our mandir renovation work is in progress. It's going on at a good pace. This means we will continue with virtual satsangs for a few weeks more, and I know some of you are very happy about that. So we'll see how we adjust when Mandir reopens. Joining me this Sunday are some of our regular satsangis who have been here for the last couple of weeks, and we also have Savitri ji joining us and Yogesh ji joining us for Dholak playing, and Shami is not here, he back out to work, and he's really been with us for quite a long while, not just helping with the Dholak playing but also with technological issues. So welcome all of you, and let's have a very beautiful and inspiring morning of satsang. We started, as we always do, with praises and salutations to Bhagwan Ganesh, Gananatha, the Lord, the great Lord of the Ganas, the one who is the savior of the Bhaktas. That is all of us, because we are all supposed to be Bhaktas in every way. We follow praises of Bhagwan Ganesh by praising the Divine Mother. And we surrender to Jagadambe Bhavani, the Mother of the Universe. I invite all of you to approach her like children seeking refuge in the arms of a loving mother. As I remind you every week, please open your hearts, open your minds, clap, sing along with us, participate as much as you can and as best as you can, so together we can create powerful, uplifting and empowering energies we need to face life and to face the world. This is a very beautiful bhajan, like a chant, that Savitri Ji will lead us in. It talks about the mother who is Muskani Bhavani. She's smiling at her bhaktas as they approach her, and she's smiling because she's seeing the offerings, she's seeing the worship, she's seeing the devotion. So make sure you have all of those so that mother will smile at you. Jai Jai Bolo Jagadamba Bhavani.
Jai Jai Bolo Jagadamba Bhavani.
Jai Jai Bolo Jagadamba Bhavani.
Jai Jai Bolo Jagadamba.
And we hope you are remembering to chant the Jai card with all your love, all your energy, all your devotion in praise of the Divine Mother again. One more time. Bolie Jagadambe Mata Ki Jai. And after praising Shakti in the form of the Divine Mother, we move on to praise Bhagwan Shiva. In this kirtan, we praise Bhagwan as Parameshwara. Parama Ishwara, the one who is the great God, the one who is absolute. We offer salutations to that one whom we also called Shankara. So listen, very simple words. Shanta Ji is leading us as we praise Bhagwan Shiva.
Shiva Shankara Parameshwara Shashi Shekaraya Namo.
Namo. Shiva 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 Sada Shiva
Shiva Shankara Parameshwara Shashi Shekharaya Namo
Shiva Shankara Parameshwara Shashi Shekharaya Namo
Shiva Shankara Parameshwara Shashi Shekharaya Namo
Shiva Shankara Parameshwara Shashi Shiva Shiva Sada Shiva
Hara 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 Mahadeva
Hara 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 Mahadeva
Shiva 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 Sada Shiva
Shiva Shiva Shiva Shiva Sada Shiva
Shiva Shankara Parameshwara Shashi Shekhara
Now, before we have Pravachan, to one more bhajan. You know, sometimes people just get identified with a certain bhajan or a certain chant that they do. Even Savitri ji, sometimes when I call her, I say, Shivoham, how are you going? Because long ago, when we'd be traveling around so much, she would always lead us in the chanting of Chidananda Rupaha, Shivoham, Shivoham. Maybe I should have asked you to sing that too this morning, Sav. But I asked her to sing for us. Au Kanhaiya. We all enjoy listening to her beautiful voice singing this. So, Au Kanhaiya, we are asking Bhagwan Krishna, Mere Paas Au. Please come and be near to me. And when you come near to me, how should you come? You are the Mudali Wali. So, come playing your divine flute so that you can fill me and inspire me with your beautiful divine music. So let us join and follow along this beautiful bhajan in praise of Bhagwan Krishna. Au Kanhaiya. Please come, O Bhagwan, to bless all of us.
La 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 la. Au Murali Wali. Muraliya Bhaja. Mere paas aao इधर मेरे आंसू उधर तेरा हंसना, इधर मेरे आंसू उधर तेरा हंसना, इधर मेरे आंसू उधर तेरा हंसना, इधर मेरी मिथना उधर तेरा हंसना, मेरे गुण अंधेरे तेरे गुण अंजारे, मेरे गुण अंधेरे तेरे गुण अंजारे, आवो मुरली वागनी मुरलिया
Chandra Bhagwan ki jai. That's just so beautiful, and I'm sure, I hope it has put you in a good mood, very calm and relaxed to receive the message in our Pravachan this morning. I always like to do a quick recap of what we did the week before and see how we can connect from there. So last week, of course, it was Father's Day. And I hope all of you had some meaningful family time with your loved ones. So we shared a few verses and a few thoughts on what Father's Day can mean to all of us. And I am sharing as a quick reminder one verse from the Niti Shastra. Janakascha chopaneta cha yascha vidyam prayachati annadata bhayatrata paschaite pitarasmrita. It identifies who is a father, one who gives birth, one who initiates, one who imparts knowledge, one who provides food, annadata bhayatrata, one who provides food, and one who protects from fear. These qualities make a father. So I hope all of us are good fathers and good mothers, ajas, ajis, nana, nanis, because the same goes for all of us. So we focused on home and the family, and we shared a line that is part of one of our mantras of the years. It's something that we quote often at the Kendra. Shastra drishtaha paro dharma. And what does this mean? We saw it last week. We identified, as the Mahabharata would have said, the home is the center of the highest dharma. The home is the center of the highest duty. The home is the center of the highest ethics and code of conduct and behavior of the right path of action. So our Pravachan actually takes up from this point this morning, because we are going to look at ourselves and our role and responsibility in expressing the highest dharma, in nurturing the highest dharma, in propagating and protecting the highest dharma, in living the highest dharma. So the center of the possibility is the home, but it is dependent on whom? On all of us. So it requires from us a personal commitment and conviction. So I want to start with a quote, our Pravachan this morning, with a quote from an epic Sanskrit drama poem. I don't know how many of you have heard of Mahakavi Kalidas. You can always research about Mahakavi Kalidas. And this is from one of his poems, the Kumara Sambhavam, that deals with the love of Bhagwan Shiva and Mata Parvati, and it also deals with the birth of Kartikeya, the second son of Mother Parvati and Bhagwan Shiva. So I'm sharing with you the words of Bhagwan Shiva, what he is saying to Mata Parvati, who was involved in a very intense tapas to win Bhagwan's heart. You know, we also have to have some sense of self-sacrifice to have the grace and the love and the blessing of Bhagwan. So she was doing this very intense penance. It was extremely exacting. And Bhagwan Shiva was observing her dedication and self-sacrifice. And he said this, Shariram Adyam Khalu Dharma Sadhanam. 5 words. It's actually the last line of a whole mantra. Shariram Adyam Khalu Dharma Sadhanam. What does it mean? This body is surely the foremost instrument for doing dharma. I'll read that again, but let's see the meaning, okay? Sharir is the body. Adyam from Adi meaning first, beginning, foremost. Kalu for emphasis. Dharma. What is dharma? You know, we are the what? The followers of Sanatana Dharma, the eternal dharma. I'm sure there are about 10 of us here, and if I ask each one of the bhaktas here to tell me what is dharma, I may get maybe a range of different answers, but some similar answers. So dharma has many meanings. You can translate it like with many of our words, you can't get one English word or phrase to say what it means. So in this sense, dharma, it's about duty, it's about right action, it's about what needs to be done for not just our own good, but for the good and welfare of all. And we always say this, right, Sav? Being a Hindu is very demanding because we are called upon to be absolutely selfless. This is why in the end, when we do our mantras, we pray for Durjano Sajjano, for both those who are on the path of destruction, even those we consider our enemies. We pray for everyone. So the path of dharma, it is not a selfish path. It is a path of selflessness, where whatever we do is not only for our own benefit, but for the benefit and well-being of everything. And everything does not mean only human beings, the entire creation. I think this is why our motto at the Hindu Prachar Kendra is Atmano Mokshartham Jagad Hitaya Cha. I work for my own welfare and the welfare of the entire world. So Shariram Adyam Khalu Dharma Sadhanam, the words of Bhagwan Shiva to Parvati Mata. This body is surely the foremost instrument for doing dharma. So two words are going to come quite often in our sharing this morning. Dharma, which we've already started seeing, and sadhana. The last two words of this line, dharma sadhanam. This utterance of Bhagwan Shiva, it's an important reminder to all of us about the importance and purpose of human life. It is to be an instrument for expressing and doing dharma. Bhagwan Sri Rama said the very same thing in his maiden speech as Raja Ram when he became the king of Ayodhya. It's a well-known chaupai. If you know it, I invite you to all sing along with us. Let us see. We've just seen the words of Bhagwan Shiva. Now we are going to see the words of Bhagwan Sri Rama taken from Uttarkhand of Ramcharitmanas.
Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Shri Ram, Jai Ram. Love us up.
Shanti Ramachandra ki Jai! Jai Shri Ram!
Jai Shri Ram!
So, well-known chaupai, Bare bhag manush tanu paava, Sur durlabha sab granth hi gaava, Sadhana dham, Mocha karadwara. Bhagwan Shiva's words, Dharma, Sadhanam. Bhagwan Shri Rama's words, Sadhana Dhamma. So let's see this meaning, although I know many of you will be familiar with it. It is by bare bhag, by good fortune, one secures this human body, human life. The Shastras say this, it is not easy to obtain. So do you realize how fortunate and blessed you are, all of us, to have the human body, to have human life? It is because of our own punya, our own good karma, we are blessed to receive this priceless gift. Now, what makes this life or this body so remarkable and so special and so precious? It is this, Sadhana Dhamma Mocha Kadu Dwara. It is a gateway to freedom. It is a gateway to happiness. It is a gateway where there is no bondage, because this body is the vehicle, it is the instrument for all spiritual endeavors, for evolving spiritually, for advancing spiritually. So don't waste your life. Don't waste this precious gift. Seize every opportunity, even while we do all the things we have to do in this world that are compulsory for our welfare and well-being. Remember the purpose of life. And what does it say? Pai na jehi paraloka samvara. Don't waste this opportunity to secure your destiny in the paralok, in the hereafter. Well, the paralok, the hereafter, is about the ihalok. It is about here. Our future is about when? Our future is about now. Our future is about the present. Living the dharmic life now. Living a life of sadhana here and now. From the time we are able to. This is not for old people. We say we have the stages of life. When I get older and elder, the other day, about 2 days ago, someone is going to be an RG. So I said, what, you're going to be an RG? Well, now we may not see you at all. Because when all these grandchildren come, all the Ajas and RGs, they get so busy and all of that. So we were talking about sadhana. So I'm just remembering this because that was our conversation also just 2-3 days ago. So this life of sadhana and discipline, it should be something that is ongoing, that is happening all the time. So what is sadhana? Say this word, sadhana. What's that?
Sadhana.
Sadhana. All right, very beautiful name for a girl. And we have several sadhanas that we know. So it's derived from sadha. Sad. Sad means that which brings about, that which leads you to something. It's a means, a method to become perfect, to become excellent. So it's a path that you choose and pursue. So when you hear sad, it doesn't mean that you be what? Sad. It's the opposite. It's to make you rejoice. It's to make you revel. Not Sada Roti Krishna. Yes. So to make you enjoy a certain quality of life and a state of being. Of course, there are different types of sadhana. All right, and Raviji and I were having just a little talk about this. I had called him to get a verse, actually, and we were talking about sadhana. Last week we had Father's Day. Being a good father is what? It's about sadhana. Your fatherhood is about sadhana. Your motherhood is about sadhana. Being a good child is about sadhana. Being a student, look, everyone is under pressure right now for exams. Undue stress, unnecessary stress. So it's not really enjoyable at all. But that also, it's about sadhana. It's about discipline. So if we see whatever duty we have to perform, whatever path, if we see this and view this from the context of sadhana, just think how different our lives and this world will be. So don't forget, this body, it's what? Sadhana Dham. Bhagwan Ram said that, and the very same thing, Bhagwan Shiva. Dharma Sadhanam. I want us to join in to sing just the chorus of our mantra of the year 2002, which is actually about this Chaupai. So as you reflect on what we have just said about life being about sadhana and noble pursuits, let us sing this together. We have sent the copies, so I hope you have it with you to follow along, just the chorus.
Bari bhag manusha tan pavava sadhana dham moksha kar dwara remember Shri Rama said to Ayodhya bari
Chandra ki jai. Follow the words with me. Very beautiful. All of these composed by Raviji. You have a varadan, born as a human. You have a boon, all of us. We have a boon, a special, it's a privilege, a great blessing to be born as a human being. You have a varadan, born as a human. This is a mandir for liberation. Body, life, it's a mandir. It's our first mandir. For liberation, for freeing ourselves. So let your dear light, when? Only in the evening, when we go to light our evening dear, the one in the home? No, our light should be all the time, the light of knowledge, the light of love. So many beautiful virtues, they represent light. Always remember when our tradition talks about light and the darkness, it is referring to wisdom and ignorance. So may we always be blessed with light. And every time we light a dia, may we remember to also in this mandir, make sure the light is burning very brightly. So this really captures in essence what we have shared so far. So I want to present a dream world to you. If I ask you all, what is your dream world like? You know, what do you see? Of course, for this world, we all wish for peace. We all wish for equality. We dream of so many things. There's so much of instability in our world today. There are crises everywhere. And we pray for peace. We pray for everyone's well-being every time we do our mantras. And sometimes when we see all the tragedies, we really feel returning to an ideal state of existence is impossible. But it is not impossible. It is possible. Our Shastras, Bhagwan Sri Rama, is saying it is possible. But who makes that possible? We. Each one of us. It's our duty. This is why if we can understand Dharma Sadhana, all of us, and do what is required, we can have this dream world that is being described here. Let us hear in the words of Tulsidas Baba, these Chaupais, as the rule of Bhagwan Sri Rama is being described here. Join with us.
Jai Rama, Shri Rama, Jaya Jaya Rama, Shri Rama, Jai Rama,
राम राज नहीं काहु ही व्यापा दैहिक दैविक भौतिक तापा राम राज नहीं काहु ही व्यापा जय राम चरण सेवक नर नारी सब उदार सब पर उपकारी विप्र चरण सेवक नर नारी
जय राम श्री राम जय जय राम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम जय राम श्री राम जय जय राम श्री राम
श्रीपति रामचंद्र की जय जय श्री राम सो व्हाट आर वी डिस्क्राइबिंग अ ड्रीम वर्ल्ड समथिंग दैट वी थिंक दिस इज ओनली अ ड्रीम इट कैन नॉट बी अ रियलिटी बट इट्स नॉट सो ड्यूरिंग रामराज सो वी सी द वर्ड रामराज नहीं काहु ही व्यापा इट केम इन द सेकंड लाइन ड्यूरिंग द रूल ऑफ भगवान श्री राम Where there is ideal leadership, where there is one who genuinely cares, who looks after the welfare of everyone, there was what? No suffering. Daihika, daivika, bhautika, tapa. Tapa means where there is affliction, misery, there is difficulty. So this is called tritap. See, in our tradition, there is tritap or tapatraya. Suffering, afflictions, misery, difficulties. There are three categories, which I'll share very quickly with you. You can also, I encourage you to always try to read, because remember, we are just spending 1 hour, and sometimes I may go quickly with certain things, because we don't want to go beyond the hour. So you can always call, message, or some of you have been doing, and you can also read for yourself. So the first one is Daihika Tapa, or what is called Adhyatmika Dukha, that is pertaining or related to the mind and the body. So we can feel unhappiness, suffering, affliction, difficulty because of that. Then there is daivika tapa or adhi daivika dukkha. Dukkha means sorrow or suffering from unseen forces, things that we really have no control over, natural disasters and so on. And then there is bhautika tapa or adhi bhautika dukkha, pertaining to living beings, those who cause what? Distress to others, unhappiness, suffering, and so on. So this is what is given here. Such things did not exist during the rule of Bhagwan Sri Rama. Sabanara karhi padas padapriti chalahi swadharma nirata shruti niti. See this. Everyone loved each other. Everyone loved each other. Everyone respected each other. Each one followed his swadharma. Swadharma, his prescribed duty. Can all of us do the same thing? Look, we have a master seamstress here. I can't sew properly in a straight line. Give Savitri G skilled in her sewing. We have people who can sing. I can't do the technical things. I can't play the harmonium up till now. So what? Everyone has that special skill or talent, our swadharma, our path, that which we can pursue and excel at and use that to also what? Support ourselves, but to serve and to help others. You just think, if a simple thing, like there were no cleaners, there were no people collecting garbage working, there were no, it happened to us, we were experiencing that only recently. So what happens? There's instability, okay? So everyone followed his or her swadharma. What was his duty? And it maintained the balance of the society because each one was supporting the other. And very importantly, it says here, Chalahi Swadharma Nirata Shrutiniti. People behaved and lived according to the injunctions, according to the guidance and the teachings of the Shastras. We have to know our Shastras. We have to know what is taught. We have to know what is written. And in Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan Krishna says the same thing to Arjuna in chapter 16, verse 24. Well-known verse also. Tachmach chastram pramanam te karya karya vyavastitau nyatva shastra vidhanoktam karma kartum iharhasi. Let the Shastras be your authority in deciding what should and should not be done. Of course, our Shastras also say that if you don't have this knowledge and you don't know this, look at how the good people live. Look at how noble elders live and follow. So understanding the teachings of the Shastras, we are asked to live accordingly and perform our actions in this world. It also says in this Chaupai that we shared, Chadiyu Charana Dharma Jagamahi. Dharma again, with its four pillars are described here. What are the pillars? Truth. To be truthful. Purity. Where there is honesty, people don't misrepresent themselves. Where there is compassion, kindness, and where there is charity. Supporting, giving, sharing. Okay? So this is what? It reigned throughout the world. It existed everywhere. No one even dreamt of papa. No one dreamt of hurting others. This sounds so impossible because we have strayed from that so far, from that which is ideal, that we think, nah, can't happen. But it can. We may not see it in our lifetime. These young ones may not see it in their lifetime, in many, but we have to what? Work towards it. So this was possible. People could live like this lovingly, respectfully, supporting each other, the men and women. Saba udara saba pada upakari vipracharana sevaka naranadi. The men and women of Ayodhya, they were service oriented. Do you know why? If you remember last week, I was describing Raja Dasarath and Raja Janak, Dharma Dhurandhar. The fathers, the kings, the elders, the leaders, they lived according to Dharma, Parama Dharmavit. They had the knowledge of Dharma. Sri Rama himself is described as Kula Dharma Parayana, the one who advances the Kula, the one who advances the lineage. How? By doing dharma, okay? And sometimes when I'm talking to the children, we say, do you know what is right and do you know what is wrong? Who here doesn't know? All of you, well here, but all of you listening to me, we all know what? What is right and what is wrong. But we are like Duryodhan in Mahabharata. in many ways, and I share this with you. Actually, this is also mentioned in the Pandava Gita and in the Panchadashi, when Duryodhana, the mighty prince, the warrior, was asked, "You are such a great prince of good lineage, of good family, and brought up well. Why do you do such horrendous things?" And he describes the human condition. We are no different from Duryodhan. What does he say? Janami dharmam natchame pravittihi. Janami adharmam natchame nivrittihi. Janami dharma. I know what is dharma. Yogesh, and you know what you have to do? What you have to do right now? Sit and listen. When satsang is over, they all start, it's a different. So we have to know when to follow. We can be disciplined. All of us, we can be disciplined. So it says here, I know dharma. I know it. I know what I have to do. I know what is right. I know what is required. But I am just unable to do it. I am unable to practice it. And then he says, janami adharmam. I know very well what is adharma. I know what is wrong. But I am unable to stop myself from doing it. This is the human condition. And do you know, if you think of it, think of Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna was also at a point where he could not what? Do dharma. He was caught also. He had his own doubts, his own difficulties. He knew what was right, you know, but somehow like he just couldn't pursue that path. So he needed the counsel, the divine counsel of Bhagavan Krishna to help him and to guide him. And he was able to listen to make a dharmic world possible. Duryodhan did not pursue that path. When Bhagavan Krishna says to him, to Arjuna, Nimitta matram bhava savyasachi. O Arjuna, become an instrument. Become the agency through which dharma operates. Arjuna what? Listened. Our shastras, our pravachan this morning is asking us to do the same thing. Become what? Become an instrument. We all have the perfect instrument. We all have the best requirement, that which is required, human life, human birth, to pursue the path of parodharma, the highest dharma. Let us reflect on this, because we are closing our pravachan with a special composition from the Kendra that talks about becoming the instrument through which dharma is possible. These are actually again the words of Bhagwan Sri Rama. He is speaking to Bharat. Bharat is actually just like Arjuna, you can say. He is surrendered. He has surrendered himself to Bhagwan Sri Rama. And he is asking Sri Rama for his divine counsel. And this is what Bhagwan Sri Ram describes. Listen, we have the Chaupais and we have the English meaning also in beautiful verse. Parahita Sarasa, always be engaged in your own welfare and the welfare of all, and pursue the path of Parodharma, the highest dharma. And we start from ourselves, and we are located where? In our own individual homes and spaces. This is how we build a better society and world. Let's sing together, follow your copies.
Parahit sare sadharma nahi bhai, par pira sam nahi adhamai, nirnay sakal puran mir kar, kahi baat janahi ko ved. Shri Ram Jai Jai Ram.
Follow in your copy and you can read along with me. This is just capturing so beautifully again everything that we have shared this morning. Do good to others and rejoice while you are serving them. Become his instrument, Bhagwan's instrument, even as you are serving them. Who says this? So says our Dharma and so say the Vedas. So say the wise ones. So say the devas. We've spoken about human life, the human form. With this human form, never cause another pain. This is the surest way to end this karmic chain. So if you don't want to be tied up and bound by karmas, what do? You be kind. You perform good karmas. Who to blame for our sufferings? Who to blame? Bhagwan. Actually, one of the dohas from this katha, so paratta dukha pavai sir dhuni dhuni pachitai kalahi karmahi ishwarahi mithya dosha lagai. For our suffering, but we always tend to look for others to blame, and we'll say what? It's because of time. It's Kali Yuga. It's because of karma. Who's karma? Okay, it's because of my fate, my destiny. What do you say? For everything that's happening to me, it is only me. I must blame. So what do we ask for? Oh Bhagwan, bless me. Oh Rama, may I always serve and chant your holy name. So this is our Pravachan, our message for this morning. We'll chant and sing Prabhu Shri Rama's name for 2 minutes before we close. Jai Siyaram, Jai Jai Siyaram. Again, I remind you, whenever we are praising and we refer to the feet of Bhagwan Sri Rama, chanting the name of Rama, it represents a concept. It represents an idea. It is about all that is ideal and noble and good for all. So it is not just a name. The name is a symbol. So let us reflect on this. We chant together, everyone. Jai Siyaram. Jai Jai Siyaram, just for 2 minutes. Jai Siyaram, Jai Jai Siyaram, Bolo.
Jai Siyaram, Jai Jai Siyaram,
Jai Siyaram, Jai Jai Siyaram.
Oh.
Sapati Ramachandra ki jai. We join together in our closing mantras, as we do every week when we close satsang. These mantras offer prayer not just for our own selves. We pray for everyone and everything. We pray to be blessed to create and nurture that which is auspicious and good and peaceful. We pray that our leaders will lead and rule along the right path, like we have seen this morning during Ram Raja, like Bhagwan Sri Rama. We pray that all beings in the world will be happy. And let us be reminded that we are part of that process that makes this possible. Together we chant. Om Durjano Sajano Bhuyat Sajana Shantim Apnuyat Shanto Mucheta Bandhebhyo Muktas Chanyan Vimochayet Swasti Prajabhya Paripalayantam Nyayena Margena Mahi Mahisha Go Brahmanebhya Shubhamastu Nityam Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Twameva Mata Chapita Twameva Twameva Bandhuscha Sakha Twameva Twameva Vidya Dravinam Twameva Twameva Sarvam Mama Deva Deva Om Dhyau Shantir Antariksha Gum Shanti Prithivi Shantir Apaha Shantir Aushadhaya Shantir Vanaspataya Shantir Vishve Deva Shantir Brahma Shanti Sarvagum Shanti Shantireva Shanti Sama Shanti Redhi Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Bolye Gajanan Swami ki Shri Krishna Chandra Bhagwan ki Umapati Mahadev ki Jagadambe Mata ki Pavanasuta Hanuman ki Siyapati Ramachandra ki Goswami Tulsidas ki Bolye Sri Satya Sanatan Dharma ki Trinidad and Tobago Desh ki Jai 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 Sitaram. So thank you everyone for joining us in satsang this morning. We hope you will have a very blessed and productive week. And I want to remind you that next weekend, it is Guru Purnima. So our satsang is going to be focused on Guru Purnima. And please be aware so that if you have your gurus, you have been initiated, done your diksha and so on, you should visit and check on the guru on this day. So we will share some beautiful stotras and bhajans and of course pravachan on Guru Purnima. Thank you all. Namaskar.